Project Lifeseed is growing. Its branches are spreading like weeds across our sectors and will soon sprout life across the galaxy. But its roots are on Deminol. There, within its Imperial bunker, are the answers. Jarn Katarn had wanted to get into the base at Deminol ever since Aelor Sundown had told him what she had been subjected to. It was impenetrable, however, with the fleet orbiting and the army on the surface. But now, the fleet had been destroyed when it tried to attack them in Thal's Shroud. That left only the army, which was now vulnerable. So Jarn was able to convince General Cloudman to launch an attack. Doing so would both finish off the army and allow him access to the information he desired. They could also feed a virus into the system which could wreck much of the research the Empire had been doing on the planet. Cloudman approved, and he prepared an invasion with the bulk of their force. Everyone who was not going to Restykel would be in on this attack. They waited until the others had arrived at the Kellerman capital so the Imperials would be fully engaged. Then they landed their units on Deminol. They had no need for an orbital battle. Landing was simple when there was no enemy navy. The next part was going to be a bit more difficult. The Empire had its core infantry units in the form of stormtroopers and scout troopers backed up by an AT-ST. They also had a strange beast they were riding, one of their experimental monsters at the lab. Commanding them was General Mazoth, whom they had faced before. The scenario was bombing run, with Jarn, Scratchel, and Cloudman having the data sticks with viruses on them as bombs, the long march as the setup, and clear conditions. The Imperials with the equivalent of bombs were the AT-ST, the speeder bikes, and the beast rider, as their objectives would be to destroy the Rebel transport, and they would need large weapons to do that. The Rebels had 4 units of troopers, fully armed because of the successful supply missions they had performed, and with experience in the form of special abilities. Each unit was backed up by armored troopers sent to them by Princess Lyra, and battle droids provided to them by House Draco. Taking the lead were 3 units of commandos led by Scratchel Wilcha. They had sneaked up through the heavy woods, getting closer to the Imperial forces than they knew. General Mazoth spotted the regular infantry approaching, and ordered a bombardment with the artillery while Scratchel ordered her commandos to remain hidden. The bombardment killed 2 troopers and a sniper wounded Cloudman. The hidden commando snipers fired back, taking out the Imperial sniper team. The rest of the Rebel line moved forward as the AT-ST opened fire, and the speeder bikes flew forward. The Imperials ordered a push forward, and Scratchel spotted a weakness in the Imperial line. The stormtroopers, the beast rider, and the AT-ST fired from their positions, nearly taking out a unit of house troopers and a unit of rebel troopers. Then suddenly, out of the woods jumped another one of the experimental beasts the Empire had spawned. Its claws ripped apart 2 soldiers and its teeth bit into a 3rd. The rebels turned to it and shot it down immediately. Another beast just like the first jumped out at the stormtroopers, grabbing one by the leg and shaking it about, beating him to death. The other stormtroopers rushed back to it and beat down the creature. This gave the commandos the time to shoot down some of the stormtroopers among the trees. The speeder bikes came closer and shot up Scratchel, but she could still lead. A commando bomber threw out a charge and backed up. It blew up near the speeder bike, causing it to crash. Rebel troopers dashed up to the flank, taking cover while house troopers and battle droids pulled up behind them. General Mazoth used combined arms to mount a defense while Scratchel jumped into action. The combined arms worked, mowing down swaths of troopers on the rebel left flank. Battle droids marched down the center, and the beast rider charged into them. The rebel right flank was faring better. They shot down the other speeder bike, took down the remaining stormtrooper, and surged forward. However, Imperial reinforcements blocked their way. The snipers now focused on General Mazoth, firing at him. It did not deter the general as he ordered his troops to ready their weapons. Cloudman simply brought out the best in his troops. Stormtroopers were now trying to push forward on their right. But though they had been killing rebel troopers, they had not seen the commandos in the woods who now threw out explosive charges. So the Imperial troops stopped and fired into the woods, but only began to take losses. Behind the lines, Duri was healing wounded soldiers and putting them back into action. Jean Wraith, beside him, was transferring orders to the troops who needed them. The snipers were continuing to hit Mazoth, and he was struggling to remain on his feet. The beast in the middle was tearing through the battle droids, but they were keeping it occupied as it did. On the right, the rebels surged forward, attacking the stormtroopers hand to hand. Jarn and Scratchel rushed past them, Scratchel hurrying to the bunker while Jarn sliced his way through the stormtroopers and the scouts. The Imperials pushed an all-out assault while Cloudman united his forces to hold them off until Jarn and Scratchel were finished with their job. The AT-ST spotted Cloudman giving orders and opened up on him. The explosions rattled him, and Cloudman had trouble remaining standing. The stormtroopers and commandos continued to exchange fire on the rebel left, Imperial right. Mazoth tried to take cover behind his AT-ST, but it was no use. The sniper found him and finished him off. The beast in the center continued to tear up droids, but at a slow pace that was keeping him occupied. The stormtroopers on the Imperial left, Rebel right, were keeping the Rebels occupied as they stubbornly held on through the melee. The droids on that flank fired their rocket at the AT-ST, which was turning the corner to shoot down troops in the center, and they made a dent! Scratchel got the door open to the bunker just as Jarn finished off the stormtroopers. He hurried inside to find two of Rixar's servitors standing on each side of the console, smiles on their faces. They looked similar, not only in clothes, but in their faces as well. Jarn wondered if they were siblings. It was no matter. They lit their light whips, so Jarn did the same, standing in front of Scratchel. "I will deal with them," he said. Outside, the Empire was down to standing orders, while Cloudman ordered his troops to strike back. The commandos finished off the stormtroopers they had been exchanging fire with, and the Beast Rider finished off the droids in the center. The Rebels saw that it was free again, so they fired rapidly at them, panicking the Beast and causing it to run into the woods. Most importantly, the AT-ST turned and unloaded on the commandos in the center, wiping out an entire unit. The droids fired another rocket, deepening the dent in the AT-ST, but far too little to have any effect. Inside the bunker, Jarn leaped at one of Rixar's servitors, the one who had helped invade Zeluria and who Cloudman had seen on Zarya. Man, some of these names are very similar. Anyway, the woman smiled. This was just what she wanted him to do. She snapped her whip, but he dodged through it and swung at her. She nimbly dodged out of the way and wound up her whip for another blow. The other servitor went at Scratchel, who dodged and weaved, then rolled up to the control panel and slammed the data stack into the control panel. This would feed the virus into the machine and pull out the information they needed. The servitor wound up behind her, about to strike. Jarn rolled out of the way of the servitor who brought her whip down, just missing him. He raised his hand at the other one about to strike Scratchel, and he force pulled her to himself. She flew through the air at him and he swung straight through her belly. The top half landed on the other servitor, who held her in shock and watched the life fade from her eyes. Rage boiled over in her face, which turned as red as her light whip. She glared at Jarn, who was in a guardian stance by Scratchel, who was waiting for the data stack to reveal it was done. The servitor roared with rage, and she force-pulled Jarn. He was ready for it, so he only stumbled a couple feet, but it was close enough for her whip. She swung once, twice, and a third time, very quick for the use of a whip. Jarn tried to get in a swing, but he was having to spend all his energy dodging. He also needed to stay between the servitor and Scratchel. Finally, the data stick beeped, and Scratchel pulled it out. The servitor reached out her hand to force pull it to her, but Jarn used that moment to attack her. She had to abort her pull and instead switch her light whip steading, which caused it to suck in and become a short, stiff saber. She blocked his blows. Then she pulled out a second short saber and lit it as well. This one came out green, which confused Jarn for a moment. He didn't have time to think on it. Scratchel ran out the front door shouting, "Come on!" Jarn force pushed the servitor back a couple steps, and he leaped to the door, then ran outside. There, the AT-ST was shooting down troops, who were slowly pulling back. Another AT-ST had also arrived with more stormtroopers. The Rebels had to escape. They ran to the transport. Scratchel found Cloudman hobbling. She grabbed one side of him and Duri grabbed the other, and they hurried him back to the ship. Jarn looked back as they went, spotting the servitor standing in the doorway. Her green lightsaber was still lit, and her eyes watched him with pure hate. They would meet again. He was sure of it. Though the Rebels had retreated from Deminol, they had accomplished their mission. They had also decimated the military force there. Remember that the full battles would be quite a bit larger than what you were seeing on the screen, but they're all assumed to have done about as good as what is happening in the game. Since the Imperials were left with only one AT-ST and the remains of a couple units, they are considered to be destroyed as a fighting force. At least, as far as invasions are concerned. So they are reduced to garrison status. Elsewhere, the Empire was going into defensive mode. Having lost one of their only fleets in the sector, and now one of their only armies, they had to be sparing. House Kellerman was no longer an issue, and Strako was entangled with their neighbors. They could be dealt with later. For now, Admiral Ivar had his forces hunker down to protect their interests while they called for reinforcements. Ivar did not know it, but he had just accomplished Cloudman's main objective. The reinforcements would be coming from the neighboring sector where the Alliance was about to attack. Though General Cloudman did not know that reinforcements had been called, he had a suspicion that it had happened. The next step was to press the issue, and keep whatever reinforcements were coming focused on the Juvex sector. He looked over the map, at all the possible targets. He wanted to ask Pejix what his advice would be, but he had lost him again. This time, for good. He considered the pros and cons of several places. They could hit Dramasia again, or damage Velga or Kumara, but the Empire seemed to be reducing their presence on these worlds and may not have an impact. They could go straight for the jugular at Kath, the primary base of the Empire in this sector. Unfortunately, it was too big of a target. Data that had been brought back by Jihad Elki and Viv Ebbs on their last mission before the Rebel base fell described a massive ship that was being finished there. It was well guarded and fully operational itself. This would make it the perfect target if they had enough firepower to make a dent. But as it was, they would be destroyed uselessly. They could hit one of the houses that allied itself with the Empire, but Cloudman didn't believe that would have much effect. They could help get Kellerman their world back. After all, Sreethan had pulled many of their forces back from Piralor. But again, that would have little effect on the Empire, and Cloudman secretly didn't want to help them get their worlds back. Not until the New Republic could be established and set rules against slavery. And so that left just one real target, Carsanza. Their secondary fleet and army was there, and it was a major hub of resources and mining. If his forces made an all-out attack on that one location, and if they destroyed the army or navy there, they would bring all sorts of focus onto the sector just as the Alliance was launching their attack. It was perfect. He wanted to bring in everyone, including the forces from the Senex sector, who had been waiting in the wings this whole time. However, they had a target of their own they were about to strike, so he would have to go without them on this. This would be an attack that involved all four Star Wars miniatures games: Armada, X-Wing, Legion, and Imperial Assault. All four are included in one video. The link is on the screen. The other video is the conclusion to the RPG storyline as the team searches for the lost fleet. Click on the one you wish to see. May the Force be with you, and happy gaming, everybody.